out and all that.
And we'll see how fucking heavy this thing is, because I've already flown it. It's kind of piggy. So. This isn't really a combat maneuvering airplane. It's not supposed to be a dogfighter. It's supposed to be a go-blow-up Hezbollah type fighter, I guess. Multi-purpose, go fly into Iraq and blow up nuclear power plant type requirements. But we'll do some airshow demos with it just to see the differences between this and the standard vanilla C model F-16 without all this extra crap on it. Brakes are holding out 100%. I don't even think the vanilla one does that. I believe this one has the upgraded brakes. All right, we're going. Burner. Nose wheels off. 70 knots. Rotated about 140. We're going to go to 300 and climb to the vertical. I rotate. Gears coming up. That's really good. Hit the reset button on an accident. There we go. At 400 knots at the end of the runway, not bad. Cool, 6 G's. Start vertical, let's see how this does.
Wow, bleeds a lot of energy.
Let's put some buffeting here. It's still morning, here we go.
Altitude.
Some knots.
Altitude.
Pull up. Cuban there.
Altitude.
Straight into the 60. And it bleeds energy. I have a touch of throttle. 13,000 pounds, and I mean, it's holding 300 knots. It's not bad. 3G pounds. It's got, like, good pull characteristics. The other one was just so instantaneous. I mean, it's supposed to be a dogfighter, but this just seems a little more tame. conscious, no auto GCAS, but see how quickly we accelerate down to damn near speed of sound without even touching the throttle. That's a mil. Wow.
Altitude.
I break the sound barrier. Came close. High alpha is going to be like 200 knots on this jet. I'm curious what the max alpha we can get with this configuration. 1,500 feet.
Bingo. Bingo. See how the air braking works. Pretty good. Gives up around 103 knots. Big Jewish brakes. Slow down really nice. They did a good job with this model.